Hi everyone, the topic we are going to study in computer network here in this video is the forwarding technique and forwarding process in network layer. When a packet is to be transmitted from a source to destination, the network layer is actually collecting a data from upper layer and packing all the data and forwarding the data to the destination. So what are the process to be followed when the network layer is transmitting a packet? So we will see first how internet communication happening over and different networks and the techniques to be followed to simplify the complexity of a routing table. This diagram here is showing how internet communication is happening. Say the network N1 and here network N2. Simply a network N1 is a local area network connecting several devices, like here system 1, 2, 3, 4 are connected with a switch, that is local area network device, and here also in network 2 several devices are connected with the switch. When these different networks want to communicate to each other, then inter-network device, the router, is a connection device that is connecting a several network, a system, a host in a network, transmitting a data through router and in a different path to another system in other networks. So what is the role of network layer here? Let us take the example of the system 2 wants to transmit data to the device here in the network 2. The path actually travels here in a local area network. It is initially connecting to the switch, and this switch is connecting router R1, and the path is actually followed by R2, R3, and this symbol is of switch, wide area network switch, and it is actually connected like this, and again followed by R4, R6, and finally reaching the network N2. Here, the system 2 in network N actually collecting the data from the upper layer, the application layer, and the role of network layer is to collect a data from upper layers and grouping all data, that is packing all data together, and the next data link layer is adding additional information and transmitting through the path. So here network layer is actually involved in the host, that is in the network 1, and in router 1, router 2, router 3, router 4, and in all routers connected through this path. Here only single path is shown, but there may be the system, the network N1 may be connected with different paths. The role of network layer is to find the best path and forwarding the packet through the path. From TCP/IP protocol, the device, when the data is transmitted from system 2 in a network 1, data starting from application layer to the transport network data link and physical layer, and the packet is reaching the router R1. If router is transmitting only a packet, only first three layers are playing the role. Though other upper layers are required for the controlling purpose, when your router is only transmitting a packet, only first three layers are used. So these layers are shown for the network, the system in a network, and these layers for all routers. Two data link layers and physical layers are connected to each router. The router has to find, it actually maintains a table. Table contains all information about the destination network and the interface to be connected. This is the packet. See, this is the data to be transmitted. This is the data which is arriving from the network 1, and it is initially searching the network address. If the network address is matched and the corresponding interface is used to transmit a packet further. So let us see what are the techniques to be followed to simplify a routing table complexity. The basic role of the network layer is to packetize the data. Next one is finding the best path and forward the packet. As we have seen, when a host or a router have a packet to be transmitted, then the host or a router must have the routing table or a forwarding table. containing all the information about the destination. So generally forwarding is defined as placing the packet in its route to its destination. Once the path is found, the network layer is finding the path, then the packet is placed to its destination. And when a host is having a packet to be transmitted, or router received the packet from a host to transmit, then both should have a routing table. So the routing table contains all the information about the destination host. So let's see, the first method is route method versus next hop method. Next hop method is simplifying the complexity of a routing table. So this is the internet work. Say host A in this network is connected with the host B in this network. In between there are interconnection. The internetwork devices, say R1, R2 are there in the path. Here general routing table based on route. Say when a packet is transmitted from host A, that is the host A has packet to be transmitted, then it should have a routing table. So the routing table for host A is this one. That is, its destination is host B. It wants to transmit a packet to host B, so that it should have information about the path, that is R1 and R2 connected in a path, and the final destination host B. And this router should have the knowledge about R2 and host B, and the routing table of R2 must have the knowledge about host B. So rather having all the information over a path from host A to host B, we do follow the next hop method. Next hop. Hop means a trip. When a packet is transmitted to next router, say the path between one router to another router. In next hop method, when a host A has packet to be transmitted to host B, it should have the knowledge of its next hop, that is R1. And no need of information about R2 and host B. When the packet is reaching R1, the routing table of R1 in next hop method, it should have the knowledge about R2. It has only entry of R2, and this router 2 has the knowledge about host B destination. So using next hop method, the complexity of routing table based on route method, that is, instead of having all the information over the path from host A to host B, the table contains, the routing table contains only the next hop detail. And next, host specific versus network specific method. That is, network specific method is actually simplifying the complexity of routing table. Here two network is shown, that is network N1 and network N2 are connected with the router R1, and the router should have the information about the destination. So by following the routing table on host specific method, the router should contain the information of all individual devices in network 2. That is, it should have the information about A, B, C and D. When we go for network specific method, we know the first IP in a network 2 is the network address, and the last IP is the broadcast address. So when we follow network specific method, the router can have only knowledge about the network. That is, it will identify only the network N2, and it doesn't worry about the devices whatever there in network 2. So we will see the process, forwarding process in this case. So host specific means router should have the information about the host A, B, C and D in network 2. But in case of network specific method, router no need to think about the host, all the information about the individual host. It has knowledge of only the network, the name of the network. Next technique, forwarding technique we can follow here is default method. In default method, say network N1 is connected to network 2 with the router R1, and rest of the internet network is connected with the default router R2. So only the network address depending on N2 is connected through R1. So whenever the network address connected with N2 are actually processed through R1, that is, the packets are forwarded through R1, rest all other addresses to rest of the internet network are processed, that is, forwarded through the default router R2. So the host or a router, when it has a packet to be transmitted or when a router received a packet to be transmitted, both must have the forwarding table, routing table, and in the table it contains the information about destination network address and the interface. And to reduce the complexity, when more number of systems are there in the network and all information, rather having all the information, we can go with the next hop method. The next hop method, the router table required to have information about only next hop, the router, about the router or the device destination. Thank you.